Chelsea and Brandon, I just want to thank you all very much for having me a part of your day. It's been a beautiful day, and I wish you all the best in your future.
Prior to introducing you to the parents and our wedding party, first of all, Chelsea's grandparents, let's have a nice big round of applause for Mrs. Helen Aiken. Give it up for her out there. And also Mr. and Mrs. John and Virginia Everett. Let's hear it for them as well. And Brandon's grandparents, let's hear it for Mr. David Kelfman. Come on, there we go. And Miss Linda Newell, let's hear it for her as well. And of course, Mr. and Mrs. Walter and Debbie Taylor, give it up for them out there. And at this time, we'd like to introduce you to Chelsea's parents. Coming in the room, let's have a nice big round of applause for Mr. and Mrs. Eddie and Lisa Wrightson. Walter and Debbie Taylor. And let's give it up for Brandon's mother, escorted by Pat Faulkner. Let's hear it for Barbara Spady. Flower girl and our very handsome ring bearer. Let's give it up for Alani Aiken and Connor Smith. Brittany Spady, with another one of our bridesmaids and Chelsea's college roommate, Barbara Ann Griffo, escorted by a groomsman and Chelsea's brother, Alex Richard. Give it up for those three coming in. Escorted by one of our groomsmen and Brandon's cousin, Nathan Spady. All right, you guys, and coming in next. Yeah, that's right. Let's give it up for bridesmaid and best friend from high school, and Melissa. Also a best friend from high school, Abby Nashin, escorted by our other best man, Daniel Samuels. and make as much noise as you possibly can as we welcome in Mr. and Mrs. Brandon Chase Spady! To join together in their first dance as husband and wife.
Thank you once again for all your support that you gave these two over all the years. okay? Thank you and enjoy yourselves. I love having a pride in right now. And Brandon, you know, all I can tell you is the women in this family, they do not go away. They live on and live on and live on. You know, we got the 101s in here, we got the 199s in here, so. We got the 89s and the 92s back here. You know, you may have to look forward to that. You know, so keep working out, staying in shape.
He's got the retirement.
Yeah, retirement comes soon. All right, so love you both, and congratulations. Everybody enjoy yourself tonight. Thank you for being here.
Chelsea and Brandon, I'm so happy for both of you, and I can't wait to start this party tonight and for the rest of your lives to be beyond perfect, and I love you both more than anything.
Speaking of all the special ones.
Good evening, everyone. It is my honor and pleasure to welcome each of you to this happy wedding celebration here at the Chamberlain by the Bay. In addition to our Virginia guests that we have here, we have guests from North Carolina, Florida, Delaware, New Jersey, Massachusetts, Michigan, and Kansas. Last but not least, my granddaughter and great-granddaughter flew in from the French West Indies. We are so grateful to all of you. And just welcome you here. And now I think that in keeping with Virginia hospitality, I think all of our Virginia natives ought to welcome all of our natives from out of state and out of country. So let's give them a hand of applause. Give us, Lord, our daily bread. Thanks be to God. God. Amen.
Amen.
Bon voyage, Chelsea.
Here we go.
to do it this time. So if we could go ahead and clear everyone off the dance floor, except for Chelsea and her father, Walter. So Walter, if you would, come on out here to the dance floor.
Lying there in bed, to be warm, to cry, made to walk.
Brandon and Barbara out on the dance floor, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for Matthew.
Come join us out here.
wedding was a beautiful. Sorry none of us kept it together, but what did you expect? We love you guys so much, and me and Kelly obviously can't wait to move in with you guys. And sister wives, we're going to be filmed together.
It's
just like this.
So
this is
great.
The start of the filming, if you didn't know. But
me too.
I don't know. But you guys are perfect together. Honestly, you guys complete each other. Anything that y'all don't have, the other one fulfills. And I wish you the best. And I know everything's going to be so great. And I can't wait to be a part of your lives.
Hey, Chelsea and Brandon, I love you both and wish you the best in your new life together.
I've loved y'all all my life, every time I've met you. So I want y'all both to know I'm here. Best wishes to both y'all. If you need anything, I'm right there by your side. I love y'all both.
Chelsea and Brandon, oh my gosh, that was the most beautiful wedding I've ever been to. I love you guys so much. Everything was perfect, and I'm ready to get started and party. So I'll see you in a few. I love you guys, and I wish you the best. Mwah.
Guys, in just a few minutes, we're going to be doing our toast. So if you do not have a drink, or if you need to go get a drink, now would be the time to do it.
Hello, hello, hello.
I got all that out.
All right.
no. I'm so out of shit, too. From the day I met you, you know, I knew I wanted you to be my best friend. And I knew that it wasn't for the obvious reasons. It was because I left and went home with a black eye and a bruised voice box. I knew from that point I wanted you on my side and not anybody else's. it wouldn't be good for me. If it wasn't me and you together, I need you in the outfield making diving catches for me. I need you with the late gasping. Just being right beside me and my best friend. Or coming to you at 11:30 at night saying, Brandon, it's the work night tomorrow, but I need you here for me. You're right there. And I really appreciate it. I do. I love you like a brother. You know, they say that friendships, they can last. And at some time, they tear off. Because once you get married, you know, you're intended to be in your life. And you focus on that. I'm not going to let that happen. You know, I look forward to the day where we're vacationing together and I'm waking you up and jumping on your bed like you're waking me up on vacation. We're all of us growing up. And you're like, hey, I'm ready to go. 8 o'clock. Let's go surfing. Or let's go, you know, do whatever on the beach. I'm that guy. So, you know, we've had so many amazing times together. And there isn't one person in this room that I don't want to stop hugging you. Because I cherish our friendship. I love you like a brother. I love you since the day I met you. And you're an amazing friend and brother. And I just really appreciate everything you've done for me. And, you know, there's been so many times where I've done something and you've come behind me like, Rob, that's not how it's done. Let me show you how to do this. I've always appreciated it because I'm like, okay, well, he does it in a manner where it's like, hey, you're still my buddies. And I just want to say, I'll let you know, I just want to say I love you. You are my best friend. And, you know, you're everything that I could ever ask of you. And I really do appreciate everything you do for me.
And it was
I would be lying if I didn't say that today. I still daydream about those moments and those times in our life. And Brandon, I know that you're going to take care of my girl. I know that you are a lucky man to have a woman so caring and so elegant in your life, and someone that has shown you so much love and so much warmth and will bring sunshine to your life every day, just like she's brought sunshine to mine. I love you guys.
We love you.
Everybody here has voiced their opinions about how great Chelsea is and how wonderful she is. And, you know, I can't agree anymore. You know, she started off in school and, you know, first of all, I didn't know she was going to, like, pre-kindergarten. Then I hear she's in kindergarten, and then I'm like, okay, so how long is this going to go? She's in Trinity Lutheran there, Christian school, and did real well there. And she's just, first thing I know, she's going on into middle school. And I'm like, okay, she's somewhat been, you know, I guess, pacified into the Christian school there where she's taken care of and advanced education and really, you know, keeping her on top of her schooling. So how's she going to do in public school? And she got into public school, and I think her first year she was like a little ahead of everybody else. So she was a little, I think, bored in the first year. So. But, you know. So I'm not sure where she gets all the smarts from, her dad or her mom. But anyway, she's done real good in school. She's always done real well. She's always been on the honor roll. And I remember, I think one time, I'm not mistaken, it was a high school, I think. And I remember coming home, and I remember crying, and I was like, what's wrong with her? And I think Alex said, she got a C. And I said, really?
And so, that's
for
like $3?
And yeah, and she was going to miss out on the collection on the money, but I was paying her for A's and B's and stuff like that. So now she's getting ripped off because now she's got a C there. So anyway, you know, Alex is over there going, God, I'd be happy with a C. You know, what's wrong with that?
Why are you crying?
Yeah, why are you crying? So she's always doing real well in school. So, you know, to be a parent of a child like that, and I know that Lisa and Eddie, myself, and Debbie, I really appreciate what she's done for us to make that part of her life easy for us. And, you know, she's always got a lot of other ones, though. You know, there's plenty of other ones, but to have a kid that's really does well in school, and you don't have to worry about it because she's her biggest challenge. She's always wanted to be the A and B kid. What she wanted to be. And she's, I don't know hardly when she wasn't on the honor roll in school. And, you know, so then she goes on to college and she graduates with honors. Never ended. And then she gets out of school. And, okay, I'm thinking, all right, what's Chelsea going to do now? You know, where's her life going? What's she want to be? You know, she's majoring in fashion design. Is she going off to France? Is she leaving? Is she going to live with Ashley or what? You know? And so I was kind of surprised, you know, that she found a job. She said, I'm going to work at CNU. She leaves the college to go work for a college, so good for her. Good job. So we've been real proud of her. She's made life a lot easier for us. And I think a lot of people think about Eddie and Lisa and I and Debbie and how the four of us get along and how well we get along, and I think it's all because of her. You you know. So. So, without saying, you know, I love her. So, but then we got Brandon. So, you know, Chelsea's not gonna get all the credit. You know, Brandon's been right there with her. And you know, the first time that they came out and I met Brandon, Brandon eating the plate off, the food on my plate. I was kind of like, you know, this kid's really a good kid, you know? I mean, he don't mind eating leftovers, you know? And he finished mine, and then he looked over at Debbie and goes, you gonna eat that? So, there was no shyness, and it was easy for him to just kind of fall right into family. And, you know, we've loved him ever since. I don't know what I could do without him being around or talking to him and coming to visit and asking me about directions on stuff that he was, I'm going to work on this project at home. I'm going to, you know, we do the sprinkler system. I'm going to dig this well. I'm going to fix the well pump. I'm going to do this.
And
he comes down to my house in Florida and he's like, I can crawl up in the ceiling, I can wire the lights, you know, we can do that, you know. It's like, okay, you can crawl up there and I'll run a wire up to you. So he just jumps right in and he really wants to learn a lot of stuff about life and you know, having a house. And, you know, they have a house together right now, and Brandon and them are looking for another house right now. He's put a bid on, and hopefully that'll come out for him in a lot of work, because I know Brandon's already got his plans for it. He's already got his plans to work in the yard, fix this and fix that. For years we went and watched Brandon play ball. And there's a couple, I guess I'll call them buddies that he has in here.
Robbie and Daniel.
We watched these guys play ball and stuff, and 2006, I guess you guys, they were the beat baseball team to beat back in, I think it was 2006. And y'all guys look like, what, 26-1? So, did a real good job. You and Robbie did. He was dancing on the mound a whole lot there, too. So, he's got most of his boots from being on that mound. But, you know, Brandon, what's that? Oh, Brandon.
I got it for Brandon.
And so, without saying, you know, Brandon went on to school. He graduated from Virginia Tech. And he worked for the Northrop Grumman there for a while. And as a student, while he was going to school, and they snatched him up when he got out of school. So. Good for him. So he's on his way. He's got a job now. He's out of school. And he's all ready about life. So all he's now is looking for is a wife. So that makes everything complete. So I knew that it would be short-lived to be together. And I'm happy they are. So I only have a couple things for you two that I want you to say. And before I propose a toast to you two, Brandon, I want you to repeat after me.
I hear you, Walt.
All right. So, Brandon, what I need you to say is, I'm sorry, dear. I was wrong. To remind both of you of your obligations and stuff to each other over the coming years, and what role you play with each other. And Chelsea, I need you to say,
And these are both items that you both switch over at different times and say. But just keep these in mind with your wife. Don't worry, dear, it doesn't matter. So y'all keep those in mind when times are bad, things are rough. Keep those in mind and just think about it. I'm sorry, dear, and things just don't matter. Okay?
Hey.
So I started planning for this speech probably 6 months ago. I didn't write much down, and I figured that I could do as good as Robbie did, so I figured as long as I could follow him, I'd be all right.
Alex has to follow you.
So, but for now, you know, it gives me my pleasure to introduce those two as husband and wife, and I wish them to the best of everything.
Care.
So much. Y'all had such a beautiful wedding. Brandon, I'm sorry. I tried to keep it together, but as soon as I saw your face and I saw the waterworks, I lost it. So I apologize, but the wedding was absolutely beautiful. I'm so happy for you guys. And bye.
Love you guys. Have fun.
I'm not really sure who the two guys are in the back there, but that's all right. Are you ready? Chelsea, you can go ahead and slide off the dance floor one more time. Let's give it up for our lovely bride, everybody. Let's hear it for Chelsea. Look, like four of them are like, no, we're really not ready for this, sorry. We're gonna do it on the count of three, just like we did with the boot camp. You might need to move a little closer there, Brandon. A little bit closer to him. That thing doesn't fly quite like the bouquet does. All right, here we go. On a count of three. One, two, three. Who's got it? Is that Robbie? Give it up for Robbie, our lucky garter catcher out there.
Thank you. Yeah. stay. And though we've only just begun, the quest until we're old and gray is the vow.
Tried to beat you, but you're so hot that I melted. I fell right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to get back. Before the cool done run out, I'll be giving it my bestest. And nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some or learn some. But I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait, I'm yours. Well, open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn, you're free. I look into your heart and you'll find love, 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 love. Listen to the music of the moment, people dance and sing. We're just one big family, and it's our God-forsaken right to be loved. Love, 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 love. So I won't hesitate no more, no. Time is just to try to see it clearer, but my breath fogged up the glass, and so I drew a new face and I laughed. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid yourself of vanities and just go with the seasons. It's what we aim to do. Our name is our virtue, but I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait, I'm yours. Open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn, you're free. I look into your heart and you find that the sky is yours. So please don't, please don't, please don't. There's no need here to complicate, 'cause our time is short. This, oh, this, oh, this is our fate.
Good night.